We all know that dreaded feeling of hitting a plateau, but why exactly does it happen? Well, let's talk about it. A fitness plateau, in a general sense, is simply when your progress towards a fitness goal significantly slows down or comes to a complete stop. Now, there's a lot of reasons why this can happen. For this video, though, we're going to focus on the specific plateaus we run into, despite the fact that we're still doing seemingly all the right things to promote progress. This is a sign that physiological changes are occurring in response to progression itself, which, in my opinion, is the truest form of a plateau. Plateaus related to other factors, like problems with your program, dealing with injuries or age-related limitations won't be the focus here. Besides, I think the answer to those plateaus are quite self-evident. So with that in mind, let's get started. Again, plateaus are related to physiological changes that occur in response to progression. That's why when we're beginners with no progression experience, we tend to see the most rapid development, which is commonly referred to as newbie gains. Eventually, though, those newbie gains will come to an end and progression slows down. But why does this happen? Well, our bodies and muscles are actually very sensitive to any new form of training stimuli, which allows for greater adaptations, thus greater development. And in the beginning, everything we do is essentially new stimuli. Our muscles even experience tears at the molecular level when we start lifting weights. But over time, as with most things we do over and over again, the body starts becoming desensitized to the training and require even more stimuli to promote further development. We'll also experience fewer muscle tears, which is generally a good thing, except that the process to repair the tears actually produces quite a lot of muscle growth. Desensitization also leads to slower rates of muscle protein synthesis, the primary physiological process that drives muscle growth. We also start becoming more efficient with our training patterns, leading to slower neuromuscular development. Pair that with slower muscle growth, we then see slower strength gains. Ultimately, the desensitization leads to significant drops in progression through various physiological factors, leading to our first genuine physiological plateau. And research puts this first plateau at around 6 to 12 weeks of consistent training, although it can vary from person to person. Now, obviously, we can still make plenty of progress even without newbie gains. However, beyond this point, we'll likely run into even bigger plateaus. This is where we start experiencing genetic limitations. Essentially, our bodies are genetically programmed to actively avoid too much progress. The thing is, because of how metabolically demanding the process is, maintaining non-stop progression is actually a very inefficient way for our bodies to function. It's also very metabolically demanding just to maintain whatever progress we've already made, especially the muscles we gained. So in order to preserve our body's resources, we all have a built-in genetic ceiling for progression. And when we get closer to the ceiling, mechanisms that limit progress become more active. Now at the moment, researchers have yet to identify the precise process of these mechanisms, and we have yet to discover how to identify anyone's personal genetic ceiling. But the science has shown that there are indeed greater physiological limitations the further we progress. This is where we see even greater reductions to muscle protein synthesis rates. We'll see rising levels of myostatin, an extremely potent inhibitor of a critical anabolic pathway known as mTORC. Even our muscle cells have shown to possess some sort of mechanism that can sense its own size. And when it reaches a certain size, researchers believe it will then send out signals to prevent further growth. In short, as much of a fan as we are of progress, our bodies don't always feel the same way, which ultimately means it's going to keep making progress increasingly harder for us to achieve. And the worst part is that it's genetically predetermined, so there's nothing we can possibly do about it, legally. So the next time you hit a plateau, take it as a sign that your body is only slowing you down because it cares. If you enjoyed this video, then please give it a genetic thumbs up and share it with your plateau-loving friends. Subscribe for more and let me know what you think in the comments. As always, thank you for watching and don't forget to get your protein.